I played Dolores in the Paw Patrol movie, and she is this valley girl poodle pup, I would say, that just really doesn't mess around with the other pups. She doesn't want to be pushed around. She's really sassy, and she's so funny. I think that at first her voice was going to be a little bit raspy and we were going for something different. But then when the producers heard the cadence of my voice and how I naturally talk like a valley girl and have this kind of singing, like talking situation going on, that we changed it to be a little bit more valley girl. I think they picked the perfect character for me. She's a white poodle. I saw when I first got the offer, I saw the sketch of what Dolores would look like, and she is so cute. I had a white poodle growing up that looked just like Dolores does, so I was really excited. And just in general, to be a part of a movie like this, my kids love Paw Patrol, so they are so excited, and that just makes me happy. But I think the character Dolores just fits me so perfectly for any, if I were to pick any dog, I think this is perfect. I would say on the big screen, a dog like Dolores is perfect and something that is so needed for Paw Patrol to go and kind of branch off out of TV into the big screen to see that there's a whole other world out there of so many other dogs that aren't like them. And I think Dolores is so unique and so bougie and so feminine and so not adventurous like the Paw Patrol is. And I think that it's fun to see that on the big screen. I think you need those differences. I think that it's a known fact that my kids are the biggest Paw Patrol fans. Even what made me so excited when I was leaving this morning, I was telling all of them goodbye and telling them that what I was doing today. And my two little ones, my son, he hardly talks, he's just one, but he says like Papa, you know, like every time he wants to watch Paw Patrol. So that's like his thing. So he says that. He says Mommy and a half of a Paw Patrol. Those are like literally his words that he knows. And he always wants to watch the Paw Patrol. So and then my almost 3-year-old daughter, Chicago, is obsessed with the Paw Patrol. So I have this like my younger kids are now obsessed, and my older kids, you know, I find them if I have it on, they'll totally watch it and sneak it. You know, my 7-year-old is like too cool for any cartoons, but you know, she my what was really cute is my son was explaining to them like Mommy's gonna be the voice of one of the dogs, and for him to grasp that like they're not real, that there is a voice behind that was really cute for me to experience with them. And the two little ones did not get it at all, but I love that the two older ones do get it and they're all equally excited to see this movie, whether it's for just like my involvement or they genuinely want to watch a Paw Patrol movie. I think at least for my girls, Dolores will make the list. My son Saint is, he was a Marshall kind of guy. He really is, but then he kind of turned into the twins. He really likes the twin pups and Tracker. And then my daughter Shy, she likes Skye. And I think my son Psalm just likes any of them. It's really important as a parent, if you have all of your kids and you want them to watch something that you know that you can leave the room for a few minutes and they will be just entranced in the TV and so excited. Every little Paw Patrol event or show or the toys, like I just know that they're gonna love all of them. I love to take my kids to anything and everything Paw Patrol. I have for years. So I know it feels safe and they love it. And you know, I have four kids, all different ages, and they all love it. So it's just it's something that I feel like they grew up with watching, and it's so fun to see the different phases and the different dogs that they get into and all of the toys. And my kids are just, they love it so much. So it makes me so proud that I'm able to be one of the voices of the dogs. Like I'm doing this for them. You know, they will be so excited, and these are the kind of fun things that we can do in our lives and careers that makes our kids happy, and that makes me happy. I do think that watching the show and seeing that the dogs really work so well together and talk about teamwork and talk about helping each other and all of those amazing qualities. I love that my kids get to see that in these pups every day when they watch the Paw Patrol. And they just, you know, I think every episode just has such a good message of helping someone. And it might not even be, you know, the good guy that they're helping. And it gives them, shows them compassion, and it shows them just this empathy and just the teamwork. And I love that they can get these little messages within the show, and every episode is just such a positive message. I think it is going to be so exciting when the movie actually comes out and they could see what I did and they can see what goes into the making of a film like this. I am just so proud to be a part of the Paw Patrol family, just because that feeling of knowing that my kids love this show so much and that I can be a part of the first ever movie that they're making about it and get to bring my family and show them just makes me happy that I can make them happy. And I think it's been really fun. I love doing new experiences, so being the voice of an animated character is something that I really wasn't used to, but something that always pushes me, and I'm just grateful for the experience of just doing something that's outside of my comfort zone that I can try and grow and make my kids happy all at the same time.